Mr. Cruz, welcome. Good to have you here today.
Great to be with you, Martha.
It's great to have you. Explain this to us. Why, at this late hour, would this be discussed? It seems as if something that should have come up a long time ago and been brought by his attorneys.
Right. Well, and it should have been. And his attorneys waited years to bring this up. And it's part of the process of capital litigation is that lawyers use it to try to delay an execution. And so it's on the eve of the execution that they try to bring legal claims.
All right. So how valid is it? We've heard in a previous piece that Chris Gutierrez did on this about some of the legal back and forth. This has been to the Supreme Court. At one point, President
right.
George W. Bush said that he thought that this was a good way to protect our own people when they're in other countries, to ensure that they would have the opportunity to talk to the U.S. consulate in similar cases.
Well, 2 points, Martha. Number one, Humberto Leal is unquestionably guilty, and no one is seriously disputing that he took this 16-year-old little girl, that he tortured her, that he raped her, that he beat her to death, and as you mentioned, a truly horrific crime, and nobody in this process is questioning his guilt. So this is entirely a fight over a legal technicality, over someone that is indisputably a vicious child rapist and murderer. The second point, what this dispute all comes out of, is a decision by the World Court, which is the judicial arm of the United Nations. The World Court, in 2005, issued an order to the United States to reopen the convictions of 51 murderers across the country, including Humberto Leal. At the time, I was the Solicitor General of Texas, and Texas fought the World Court. We went to the U.S. Supreme Court. I argued the case twice in front of the U.S. Supreme Court. On the other side was the United Nations, the World Court, 90 foreign nations, and the President of the United States. And Texas stood up and fought to defend U.S. sovereignty, and we won 6-3.
So that's the precedent in this case, and the question is, what happens this time around?
Well, it's exactly the precedent. The case in 2008 that we won concerned Jose Ernesto Medellin, another murderer who, just like Leal, had gang raped and tortured, in Medellin's case, two young girls. Mm-hmm. Again, he was unquestionably guilty, and Medellin raised the exact same arguments. And what the U.S. Supreme Court concluded was two things. Number one, the World Court doesn't have the power to bind the U.S. justice system. It's the first time in history a foreign court had
right.
tried to bind our justice system. And number two, the President of the United States doesn't have the power to force the U.S. justice system to obey the World Court. That's what President Barack Obama is trying to do now.
Let me ask you this. What about this argument that comes from the State Department that says that if we, you know, don't allow his defense attorneys to put forward this claim that he was denied his right or wasn't informed of his right to speak to the Mexican consulate about his defense, that our own people will be in jeopardy when they find themselves in trouble with the law in other countries?
Well, that argument is the identical argument that was raised in Medellin, but it also is not true. The question here is not whether foreign nationals have a right to contact their consulate. They do. Nobody disputes that. The question is, after they're convicted, years later, can they raise a claim they didn't raise in trial? And you know what's interesting, Martha? I mentioned 90 nations came in against us in the Medellin case. Not a single one of those nations enforces world court decisions in their own courts. Not a single one of those nations lets you challenge a conviction based on the
right.
Vienna Convention.
Fascinating. We'll see what happens this time around with this. Very interesting and great to have you here to talk to us about it with so much experience in a similar case. Ted Cruz, thank you, sir.
Thank you for having me.